go. Yes.
And Naomi Osaka lights the cauldron. The Tokyo Games underway. It's stop.
I said something a while ago that was inaccurate about this afternoon. I guess this is the final episodes of the opening ceremony. What I was getting confused was the ending ceremony, which would be, give or take, I think about 17 days from now. So the Olympics has officially begun. This is the beginning phases of the ceremonies. I believe. I may be incorrect about that.
Opening ceremony done here live on this Friday evening, late night in Tokyo, late Friday morning back in the States. So glad you woke up with us to watch this ceremony happen halfway around the world. Savannah Guthrie, what'd you take away from that?
It was beautiful. It truly was. I love how the creator said it was friendly and gentle. And I think they really delivered on that. It really did match the time that we're in. I was blown away by that feat of technology. 1,824 drones in the sky.
Right.
Changing formation. At first, you didn't know what it was. I think the athletes were just in awe. And then it became Planet Earth. Of course, the familiar song, Imagine, arranged by Hans Zimmer. It was truly beautiful. And then the five famous singers representing five regions of the world. I thought, Tokyo gave us a moment.
They certainly did. And we were wondering what that moment was going to be. That was certainly one of them. You know, I couldn't get away from looking at the athletes. Argentina coming in, USA, the chants from the athletes, Italy, the joy that they had as they entered the field of play. It just reminded us of the joy within sport, which, because of everything going on around this, we have not focused on or discussed nearly as much. But athletes have also had a very strong point in their maturation during these difficult times. And they have spoken up, and athletes' voices have been heard stronger than ever. And to see Naomi Osaka, born here in Japan, moved over to the United States early on, four-time major champion in tennis, number one in the world, competing in these Olympics, be the individual selected to light the cauldron, I think has so much meaning, not just here, but also for the voice of athletes and the power of sports.
I have to say, I had chills when that cauldron was lit. It's absolutely beautiful. It's supposed to represent the rising sun, but then it burst open like a flower, and it just seemed like everything was blossoming with possibility. It truly was a thing of beauty.
So, this just starts the entire party. And I don't mean just for the games. I mean just for today. Still a live edition of the Today Show, a preview of the Olympics coming up. And you can join us later on tonight and watch this entire thing again, including a lot of behind the scenes with Team USA. We'll check in with Hoda and the gang back in New York as we continue live from Tokyo on this Friday.
So I was correct. They're going to redo it another opening, I guess, tonight of the official ceremony. I don't know. I don't know how all that works. I don't know if this is the official or if this is the preliminary and it works into the official. I haven't ever studied it to be able to verify one way or the other. But I did know that there was something going to be going on later on this afternoon, our time, which would be in the afternoon, their time. I knew something was going to be happening today that was supposed to have been one of the part of the ceremonial deals for the Olympics. They're still calling it Tokyo 2020 because it was supposed to be held last year. It was held off last year. This is now 2021. The athletes have showed resilience in all of this. They have went beyond the call of duty throughout all this. And we do hope that they will achieve their supreme golden memories of winning that in which what they are all capable of doing. This would do it for this particular program here coming from the Windmill Ministries. We want to thank our viewers and thank those who pray for us routinely and pray for the world. Pray for those who've been affected by the COVID, not only here in America, but throughout the world. We pray for the sovereignty of the world, not just in one particular event pertaining to the Olympics, but we pray for the sovereignty of the world all over the world in regards to peace and utopia and prosperity. Once more, we end the program by wishing everybody good luck, not just the athletes that's in competition, but we wish everybody good luck throughout the planet in a better, wholesome, more righteous, beautiful way of life that our Creator intended for us all to be a part of. Thank you for listening, and Shalom.